Hello students, today we are going to see refraction of electric flux at the boundary. So in the third unit we have considered some boundary conditions between dielectric to dielectric, dielectric to conductor and free space to conductor. So while discussing your boundary conditions, so we have discussed its use. So one of the use of boundary condition is if you know field in one medium, with the help of boundary conditions we can able to find field in the another medium. That is the one example or one use. And the one more use is we can able to find the refraction of the electric flux at the boundary. So this is a case of finding the refraction of electric flux at the boundary. So here we have considered a boundary between the two mediums. The medium one is having the permittivity of epsilon 1, and the medium two is having the permittivity of epsilon 2. So this is your medium 2 and this is your medium 1. So in the medium 1 we have considered E1. E1 is nothing but electric field intensity and D1 is nothing but your electric flux density. So here we have considered two variables, D1 or E1. And D1T or E1T are nothing but your tangential component of E1 or D1. And D1N or E1N are nothing but the normal components of D1 and E1. So while coming to the theta 1 is an angle between your D1 or E1 to the normal component. That is angle between your normal component to the original vector. Now let us come to the medium 2. Here we have defined D2 or E2 and their respect to normal and tangential component. This D2N, E2N are your normal components. D2T, E2T are your tangential component. Here also we have considered this is nothing but parallel line to this normal line. So this line is nothing but this line. So this is the angle between your normal component to the vector, that is your D2 or E2. So while discussing your boundary conditions, we got some conclusions like E1T is equal to, we got E1T is equal to E2T. One conclusion we got. So E1T is nothing but tangential component of your E1. E2T is nothing but the tangential component of your E2. So by using your, so from this diagram, so this is nothing but your, can I consider this is your E1? So this line is nothing but this parallel to this line. So theta 1, for this triangle, this dotted line is opposite side. So from E1T is equal to, we can write E1T is equal to E1 into sine theta 1, and E2 is nothing but E2T is nothing but E2 into sine theta 2. This is your equation number 1. This is from your E2T and this is from your E1T. That is E1T. So this is your E1T. So this is your triangle. So this is your theta 1 and this is your D1 N or E1 N, and this is your E1 T or D1 T, and this is your E1 or D1. Similar to this, for this one, for E2 T. So this is your theta 2 and this one is D2 or E2, and this one is D2 N or E2 N, and this one is D2 T or E2 T. So by using this triangle we got E1T is nothing but opposite by opposite into hypotenuse, E1 into sin theta 1. Sin theta 1 is equal to E1T is equal to E1 into sin theta 1, and E2T is nothing but E2 into sin theta 2. Similarly, we got for normal condition also, we got one equation that D1N is equal to D2N. Let us consider that one also. That is D1 n is equal to d to n. So from the same triangle, d1 n is nothing but this normal component. So this normal component is nothing but cos of d1. So d1 n is equal to d1 into cos theta 1, and this is d2 into cos theta 2. But d1 can be written as epsilon not into e1. So writing it as a d1 is equal to, where it d1 is equal to epsilon 1 into capital E1, and d2 is equal to epsilon 2 into capital E2. Just substitute over here. These all E1t or E2t are, these are all the vectors. So d1n is equal to d2n, d1 and d2. So d1 is nothing but, let us substitute epsilon 1 into E1 into cos theta 1, and epsilon 2 into E2 into cos theta 2. Let us consider this is the equation number 2. Let us do 1 by 2. So what is the equation number 1? That is E1 sin theta 1 equal to E2 sin theta 2. So 1 by 2. The second equation is epsilon 1 E1 cos theta 1 by epsilon 2 E2 cos theta 2. So here E1, E2 gets cancelled. So sin theta 1 by cos theta 1, that is equal to tan theta 1 by epsilon 1, which is equal to tan theta 2 by epsilon 2. So from this we can write tan theta 1 by tan theta 2 is equal to epsilon 1 by epsilon 2, which is equal to epsilon naught into epsilon r1 by epsilon naught into epsilon r2. This epsilon naught gets cancelled. Finally, you are going to get here epsilon r1 by epsilon r2. So this is your refraction angle. Tan theta 1 by tan theta 2 is equal to epsilon 1 by epsilon 2. So finally, we can write theta 1 by theta 2 is equal to tan inverse of epsilon r1 by epsilon r2. So by using this equation, you are going to find your refraction angle. So in the next class, we are going to see conductor to dielectric free space condition. Thank you.